Hi everybody, we are today by Loch Etive, which we can see behind us. This is just next to Glencoe, and today we are going up in Trelicham, which is over here, which we are going for a wild camp. Yeah, you know that it's summer in Scotland when the fern goes you basically to the neck. There's a kind of uncomfortable walking because you can't see your feet. And here we can see Ben Strava, then the Kruchen Range is up there, our Fernfield where we went through, and now we are finally basically on the V Deer Path, which leads us to the ridge, and then it should get better. And here always some rock bends, but they can be avoided or scrambled up. It's really, actually really nice walk. Yeah, there's not really much to say about the pass. It was a bit steeper at the beginning, not really exciting, but the views are just absolutely outstanding. We got a kind of a fresh breeze, that's the reason why I put this striker head back on. And I think soon we will reach a point which is marked with a little cairn with 767 meters. We are now at the 767 point, and over here is the peak behind us, and I will have now a rest. The time to have a wee snack and something to drink, and then we can tackle the summit. These views are so amazing. So we go short to the peak, and otherwise we will just wild camp over here with this views. I mean, you can't really beat it, but we need to walk a bit because the wee beasts are free again. And I forgot to say that Ben Trilchen is a Corbett with 838 meters. And here is also like a zigzag pass down, but it looks horrible steep. We're just heading here. Honestly, I don't even know why I walk to the peak, because I think you can't beat the views with a hill in it. Then Loch Etive, just outstanding. Probably just that I know that I'm not missing anything out when we go back. But right now I can't imagine any better view. I haven't seen any better ones yet in Scotland. I haven't seen much, I mean I'm not long here. But this is really unbelievably beautiful. We're reaching the top of Ben Trilchen. So on the whole trip was like nearly 1000 altimeters up. And I will have another think if I want to stay here for a wild camp or go over. I'm not sure if I like this one more. I need to have a think. Let me know in the comments what you think. I made my mind up. I go to the 767 point, which is over there, because I like the views much more. So the usual issue occurred. I flicked through my pictures, which I made on the run. And there's one spot, which was by far the nicest. And this is where we go to. And this is really the most outstanding camp spot I think from the whole tour we had. On top I loved it, really phenomenal views, but it reminded me a bit of Scandinavia. And this, what we see here, is really the best and the purest of Scotland
for my opinion, I love it so much.
And for dinner today, we have like cheese broccoli pasta and a sandwich and a muesli bar tomorrow morning. I will eat now, we have a wee breeze, it's absolutely perfect, and I switch you back on later. Naja, not spectacular. And I just checked where sunrise is, and sunrise should be over in this direction. So, and there are Monroes in between, so we won't get a great sunrise either, I think. I will still set the alarm. Early sunrise is at 5:19, I believe. So we'll set the alarm for 4:40, then we have a look, and otherwise we just pack our stuff together and hit early the road that we avoid the madness on the single track road, hopefully. So I will leave the green bit open, I will now go to bed and see you tomorrow morning. Good night. Naja, doesn't look too exciting, so I will get now my stuff slowly ready and then I think I head to the car to avoid the crowds. So folks, we are heading now down. Not looking forward to the fernwalking, probably completely bad afterwards. But I hope you enjoyed the tour as much as I did, and hey, see you next time. Bye.